Let us go ahead and get started. Thank you, everyone, for coming. This has been fantastic. I know, everyone, come on. Where's the love?
Jonathan!
There we go. This has been fantastic. I've been really enjoying myself. My name is Jonathan Turner. I'm the program manager for the TypeScript team at Microsoft. This is going to be TypeScript and Angular 2. Really kind of using TypeScript and using Angular 2 and what the advantages there. You'll see a glowing apple. Yes, I'm the Microsoft guy, but I have the glowing apple. That will play in here in a minute. But you know, I have to be a little bit legit. I have to be kind of boring slides for a few minutes, and then we get into the fun stuff. All right, so TypeScript in a nutshell. For those of you who have not played with TypeScript yet, let me do a quick recap of what TypeScript is. So TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. You start with the basic JavaScript language, which we call ECMAScript. So starting with the ECMAScript language, there are a couple of additional features. One way to think of it is like a thin layer on top of JavaScript. That thin layer will compile away to nice, clean JavaScript. So what is in that thin layer? Like, why did we build that thin layer? The first piece is this optional type system. So you can start adding types into your code, and as you do that, you can get some good error checking, early error detection. You can also get nice tooling, and we'll see that here in a minute. The type system is completely optional, so there's no requirement that you even use any types at all. You can just kind of pick and choose where you want to put those types to get the benefits. You might, for example, put them on the edge of the API, but not on the inside, so you have the flexibility on the inside of the library. TypeScript is also pulling features from future versions of JavaScript. Back when we first announced TypeScript in 2012, the kind of features we were pulling in were all ES6 features, so classes and lambdas were available years before they actually got ratified in ECMAScript. Now that ECMAScript 6 is almost done, it's nearly ratified, we're starting to pull ES7 features forward into TypeScript. All right, so how does Angular play into this? As we heard in the keynote, and as you saw in the keynote this morning, Angular 2 is built with TypeScript, and you can optionally take advantage of TypeScript to do Angular 2 development. TypeScript allows you to do that development in a way that works really well with tools. You get nice early error detection, IntelliSense and refactoring kind of built on that type system. But as Mishko pointed out, this is completely optional. You can just use TypeScript where it makes sense for you, but if you'd prefer using the just plain JavaScript, definitely feel free to do that. Angular works just fine with that. All right, that was the boilerplate, you know, paging all that information in. Let's actually take a look at what using these tools looks like. So I'm going to be writing in Sublime Text. The TypeScript team, in addition to the TypeScript 1.5, which we were talking about yesterday, with all the new features to support Angular 2, we've been working on a new TypeScript language service that makes tooling across platforms and across editors much, much easier. So this Sublime plugin that I'm using is built on this new language service. So let's actually take a look at what it's like writing Angular 2 code in TypeScript using these new tools. So what I'm going to be writing is David East's to-do MVC app, which you may have seen a couple weeks ago. This is a cool example of what Angular 2 will look like. All right, I'm going to start off by importing from a module. I don't know what I'm going to import first, but let's say I'm going to import from Angular 2. As I do this, I've got a couple of options. I can request going to a definition on that module, and I can see that this module is actually doing the job of importing more modules and re-exporting those symbols. And this is probably going to become very common in ECMAScript 6 modules. One module will flatten the API of other modules, and you'll end up with a hierarchy of modules. it's actually kind of a pain to think about what is the flat API once all these modules have been imported. But it's nice from a separation when you're actually writing the modules yourself. So what we can do is use the tooling to actually get IntelliSense for what all of those modules are importing into this file. I'll pull out, pull out Bootstrap, and I'm also going to pull out for each. We'll do this a couple more times from a couple different modules. The next one will be our DI module. I'm going to pull out bind from there. And again, you can see, I see all the imports, and I can pick the one I want. We're also going to pull in from Firebase. There'll be a couple of imports we want from there, AngularFire and Firebase Array. And finally, we have a couple of little helper functions to work with annotations that have all the nice type information. So we'll pull component template, and we actually saw these in the keynote this morning. Now that we have our imports, the next thing we need to do is actually write the class that will be the logic that we'll use. So I'll make a to-do MVC class. And then later, I'm going to export a main function that's going to bootstrap this for us. As I'm doing this, the IntelliSense is popping up to kind of help me. And it's pulling all the symbols that it's able to see. So I'll do to-do MVC. Let me take a quick second to show what we can do with just this code. Let's say I hadn't auto-completed to-do MVC, and I had just done to-do MV. Those of you in the back may be able to see there's a red squiggle underneath this. And if I click on it, it says, well, sorry, I cannot find the name to-do MV. So this is the TypeScript type checker looking through this and finding, oh, wait a second, I don't know where this symbol's ever defined. Let me give you a warning. And as you can imagine, any kind of type warning, it can warn you like this. If you have a function call that expects a string and you pass it a number, likewise, you can get that error. There's other features that come along with the type system that we can use. So for example, I can do a rename. So I'll rename the to-do MVC to to-do app. And when I do that, notice this one also changes. This is maybe not super helpful for really small examples. But as you can imagine, a large application that reuses the same word, something simple like text, over and over and over again, a search and replace can get really sketchy. Having the tools know exactly which one you meant when you're refactoring is really helpful. Let's keep filling out this class so we have the full class here to work with. I'll do a to-do service. And let's see, that's Firebase Array and a to-do edit item. Notice I didn't put any type information on to-do edit. I'm just making a couple of properties for the class, but I'm only putting type information where I care to. We'll do a constructor and make our sync. And here we'll pick, AngularFire. So this type information, you know, again, starts playing in. I can do this dot, I get all the members of the class. And if I do sync dot, I get all the members of sync. And this is coming in from knowing that this is AngularFire. Do it again. This time, we'll just set that to null. To kind of speed us along a little bit, I'm going to copy and paste the rest of these methods in. All right. And this is pretty straightforward. Notice that if you actually go look at David's to-do MVC sample, this is just copy and paste straight from there. There are no type information. This is just straight JavaScript wiring in our data service through each of these methods. We're almost done with this application. What we need to do next is actually write the annotations that are going to wire up the logic that we've set up with the different pieces of our configuration. Here, we'll use the data source, and we'll also use the template. So I'll do component. And I'll start the component configuration with an object. And here, too, I can get IntelliSense. So we know from component, we know the type of object that it gets called with, and we know the properties that are on that object. We can just give you those two properties. So I'll do to do app. And this one is a little bit long, so I'm going to copy this one in, too. All right, so if I copied correctly, we'll have the full component configured for that data source. And here too, you know, maybe just to kind of drive home a point, I can, if I had been writing that by hand, I could dot in and get the to do value method auto-completed for me. And as this tool matures, so this is still very, very early bits, very early alpha for the Sublime plugin. And you can imagine too, as you do a function call, if you start a paren, we could give you full help for what the parameters are that function needs. We also do the template, and here the same way, I get the autocomplete for the URL. And we'll set up, lastly, our directives. All right, with that, we should be done. So we've done all the imports, we've done our class, we've had IntelliSense and error checking kind of helping us along the way, and the annotations on that. So let's go ahead and build this. So the snapshot that I'm using has a snapshot of Angular 2, and also has a snapshot of the upcoming TypeScript 1.5 compiler. And I can use that compiler right now. So I'll call that with tsc.js. And if I pass it the to-do app that I just wrote, it's going to complain. So you can see that. Should make this a little bit smaller. You see it's complaining, oh, you haven't passed the kind of module system that you want to use. And if we go back and look at the code, we can see why. We've got a set of imports at the top. These are all ES6 style imports. But by default, the TypeScript compiler is going to be compiling for ES5 and ES3. So let's give it the kind of modules that we want to polyfill into. For here, we're going to use AMD. And when we use AMD, that will polyfill all the ES6 modules down to ES5. Let's take a quick look at what that code looks like now that we've had it compiled. So we start at the top, and we have the AMD-style imports. And all of that is done. Notice it's translated all the ES6 to ES5, or AMD-style. The class that we had has been translated into, you know, very common prototype pattern for the class. And at the bottom, all the annotation stuff has been compiled down to just a small section of annotations that kind of wire up the annotations for us. So if we cross our fingers, pray to the demo gods, then we should be able to run our HDB server and work. So let's go ahead and run, and now we have our to-do app working just from compiling straight from TypeScript as of today. So let's talk a bit about where we are as our status. So as I mentioned, as of today, we have a snapshot of Angular 2 building in TypeScript. We're working with Angular 2 team to start moving the tools that they're working on onto the TypeScript compiler itself. There's the to-do MVC app that David East put together. We have a version of that works in TypeScript. It's very, very similar to his original one with a little additional type information thrown in. And we have the Sublime plugin that I was showing you earlier. We're really excited to get these plugins out there and getting people using them, getting your feedback. So we'd love to hear more about that. So where are we going next? So I'm sure there are a few people a little bit skeptical about the TypeScript stuff. If you've been following closely and following the ES6 compatibility, you'll notice that on the ES6 compatibility chart of the compilers and polyfill section, we're actually the lowest support of any of the other transpilers. Oops. So this is of TypeScript 1.4, and as we mentioned yesterday, TypeScript 1.5 has a huge jump in the amount of ES6 features that we support. In fact, this nearly closes the gap. There's only a few more features after this that we still need to finish. We added annotations and decorator support so that, of course, you can do all the fun Angular 2 stuff with nice separation of concerns of your logic and your configuration and all the editor support. Nice thing, beta will be out in a few weeks. So if you want to play with what we're showing in a slightly more stable form than even what I'm showing here, you can get the beta. The future TypeScript 1.6 is coming out. We're adding generators. And lest we feel like we're standing still, we're going to start pulling in proposed features from ES7, so async await. If you do a lot of promise programming, this is super helpful to have async await there. So we're really excited. All right, if you would like to learn more, I kind of lied a little bit saying you have to wait until the beta. You can actually click on this first link or type it into your browsers, and you can get ng-conf 2015, the whole demo I showed, snapshot of Angular 2 building on TypeScript, so you get all the type information, you get the Sublime plugin, and all the libraries that we're supporting going on. You can get that now and play with it today, and you can send us your feedback. Just add an issue to the issue tracker. We'll take that as like our comment box on how this works. So definitely let us know. If you would like to learn more about TypeScript, definitely hit us up on the TypeScript GitHub website or the TypeScriptLang.org. So if you just want to read and want to learn more, there is an entire manual full of text that you can read and enjoy. And there's also the playground that you can watch kind of type code in the left-hand side and see it pop in the right-hand side. You might have seen the talk yesterday that talked about that. So big thank you again, and I look forward to hearing from you.